Hi students, today in this video I am going to teach you simple future tense. As you know that to learn every tense, three things are required to be learned. First thing is to learn time adverbs, second thing is to learn helping verbs, and third thing is to learn all the main verbs. So three things are required to be learned while learning the segment of each tense. We are going to discuss here simple future tense, and in this tense we generally discuss the things or actions which are going to take place after the time of speaking. Okay, so in simple future tense we include those actions which are expected to take place in future time. So first of all, I am going to teach you time adverbs. After that, we will discuss helping verbs and main verbs which are used in simple future tense. The name of this tense is simple future tense. We can also say future indefinite tense. Okay, simple future tense is going to be learnt by us today in this video. First thing which is required to be learnt is time adverbs. Time adverbs. To learn all the time adverbs, I have made one trick so that you can easily learn all the time adverbs of simple future tense. And that trick is INFANT, infant. Okay, infant is a word which is used for a newborn baby. Okay, so in simple future tense we can learn all the time adverbs using this short trick, that is infant. Okay, you can use your own tricks according to your own wish if you want to learn these time adverbs easily. Here it means in plus future time. In plus future time. For example, if I say in 2030, in plus future time, there is in, after that I have used 2030. So 2030 is showing future time. In this way, we can say that this is the time adverb of simple future tense. Next one, following plus time. Following plus time. Okay. Next one, after plus time. And for next plus time. And T for tomorrow. Tomorrow is the most frequent time adverb which is used in this tense. So these are the time adverbs which we have to learn this tense. The short trick is infant, in for, in plus future time, F for following plus time. For example, in the following week, in the following month. Okay, in this way. And the next one is after plus time. For example, after 2 days, after 10 years, after this decade. Okay, so in this way we can learn the time adverbs. And the next one is next plus time. For example, next month, next year, next semester. Okay, in this way we have to learn all the time adverbs, and the most frequent time adverb of this tense is tomorrow. Okay, so we do not have to ignore it. We have to learn all these things in this way, and you can make your own trick if you want to learn in another way. But I have made one trick for you to learn all the time adverbs easily. After discussing time adverbs, we required to learn helping verbs. Okay, so two helping verbs are used in this tense. Helping verbs, these are the time adverbs and The time adverbs can be learnt in this way using the trick, and there are two helping verbs. First helping verb is shall and the next one is will. Shall is used with I and will. I and will. It means shall is used with first person. First person is speaker. So shall is used with first person. Whether it is used with the first person singular, that is I, or it can be used with the plural of I, that is we. So if you see the future action and if you have to use a helping verb, in that condition you can choose from shall or will. Shall is used with only I and we. Okay, I and we. If there is I or we, in that condition we use shall. We will discuss it in examples. Will. Will is used with remaining subjects. With remaining subjects. Except I and we. Okay. So shall is used with first person, that is I or we, and will is used with remaining subject. It means there should not be I or we if we have to use will helping verb. So will is used with the second or third persons or remaining persons or remaining subjects of the language. Next point is main verb. Main verb. First thing is learn all the time adverbs, and the time adverbs can be learnt in this way. If we learn one trick, that is infant. After learning this trick, we derive the words from this trick and we write in this way. In for in plus future time, a for following plus time, a for after plus time, and for next plus time, and t for tomorrow. After that we have to use helping verbs, and there are two helping verbs which are used in simple future tense. First one is shall and the second one is will. Shall helping verb is used with the first person, means it is used with I or we. So there are only two subjects with which we have to use shall helping verb, and will is used with the remaining subject. It doesn't matter whether the subject is singular or plural. If there is not I or we, in that condition we have to use will. Okay, so remember students, it becomes just opposite when we study modals. Okay, so these are the same helping verbs or auxiliaries which can be used as a modal auxiliary verb. But remember students, when we will study modals, in that condition we will just do all the things in opposite direction. It means will is used with I and we, okay, in modals, and shall is used with the remaining subjects. And while we are studying that tense topic, in that condition we have to use shall with I and we, and will is used with the remaining subjects. Next one is main verb. Main verb is first form or base form. So first form of main verb is used in this tense. So these are three things which we have to learn in every condition to learn this topic. First, time adverb. I have given one trick to learn that. Second one, helping verb. And the third thing is main verb. I am just repeating these things for learning sake. Time adverbs. And the trick to learn all the time adverbs is infant. You can easily learn this term infant. Infant means newborn baby. The baby who has recently been born. In plus future time, in for in plus future time, F for following plus time. In this time adverb, in this structure, you will see such kind of examples like following month, following year, following semester. Okay, in the following semester, you can see that kind of structure also. Next one is after plus time, after 2 days, after 2 months, after 2 years, after 2 decades, after 2 centuries, like that. So these are the examples which we have to learn. And the next one is next plus time. In the next birthday, next party, next month, next year. Okay. And the most important time adverb of this tense is tomorrow. Okay. Tomorrow is also used in this tense. Sometimes we can also use upcoming. Okay, in the upcoming semester, in the upcoming movie. Okay, so these are the time adverbs or structures which are used in simple future tense. Next thing is helping verbs. Helping verbs, there are two helping verbs which are used in simple future tense. First helping verb is shall, and the second is will. Shall is used with the first person. It means there are two terms or pronouns which are used in first person. First person means speaker. Okay, if someone is saying something to someone, in that instance, the person who is saying something, that is considered first person. It means if I am saying something to you, I am the first person. Okay. And if there is only one person, as you can see here, I am only speaking, I am the speaker and I am only one, in that condition, this is singular. So I is always singular. Generally, this is a misconception among the students, whether they have to consider I plural or singular, because it is a very common or frequent question which is asked in the classroom by the students. For this purpose, or for elevating this misconception, I want to say one thing to you. Just consider two terms, I and we. Okay, I and we. If I say I am playing, okay, so how many persons are playing here? Only one. I am teaching, how many persons are teaching here? Only one. And this is the concept of noun or pronoun. Singular or plural is the concept of noun or pronoun. But we generally introduce this term in verbs also. And that creates this confusion among the learners or students or teachers. So I is a person, that is a pronoun, and there is only one person who is playing. So this is singular. If I say we are playing, it means there are many persons. Okay, so we is the plural of I. This one is singular and this one is plural. This is very simple thing. If I say one chalk or a piece of chalk, okay, if I say a piece of chalk, this is only one piece. And if I say there are two pieces of chalk in my hand, it means I can individually count them, one piece and second piece, one piece of chalk, second piece of chalk. Okay, so there are two pieces of chalk in my hand. There are two pieces of chalk in my hand, and this piece becomes plural. This one is singular, this one is plural. But if I say I am playing here, so I is countable. Can you count it? Can you count it? This is not easy to count I because I cannot make my own copy here. Two things which are similar cannot be made into plural. Remember students, this is very important. And if I say two speakers are here, suppose one another teacher is here and we both are teaching to you, in that condition it becomes plural of I. It means the persons who are saying something to you are in plural form. So I, one I and the second I, that becomes plural. So the plural of I is we. So do not create and confusion in your mind that I is singular or plural. I is always singular. But the verbs which are used with it, sometimes they are used in singular form, sometimes they are used in plural form, and sometimes verbs, this pronoun takes a separate verb form. As you can see here, I am playing. If I say I was playing in past continuous tense, it behaves like a singular pronoun, if we say. So was is a singular and it is used with I. Here it becomes singular. But if I say I have a book, have is used with plural subjects. In this sentence, I becomes plural. Generally, I have discussed it and I just want to say one thing to you. I is not changing its forms. I is not changing its forms. But the verbs which are used with I change their forms. There is only past continuous tense in which singular form is used with I. So in that condition you can say, although it would be grammatically incorrect to say, if we are using past continuous in that condition, it behaves like a singular subject. I was is singular and with I we are using a was. Except it in present continuous tense we use am, and there is not a distinguished form of am which can say that am is singular or plural. Okay, so it is not behaving like a singular or plural form here, because in present continuous tense three forms are used or helping verbs are used. First one is used with singular subjects. Are is used with plural subjects, but am is used with I. So it is not categorized in singular or plural form in present continuous tense. It may be a deep insight of the learning, but these things are very important, and for learning this thing you have to learn only one thing. Just focus on only one thing. If there is past continuous tense, we use singular form. In past continuous tense we use was. In present continuous tense we use am. And accept it, with all the tenses we use plural form of verb with I. I think this may be clear right now. I is singular. I behaves as a singular subject in past continuous tense. In present continuous tense, I takes am, and except these two tenses, I behaves like a plural subject. Okay, this should be very clear. Just write down one note for that. So students learn time adverbs, helping verbs and main verbs, because this is very important for us to learn. And if we can learn all the time adverbs, helping verbs and main verbs of simple future tense, in that condition we can easily write the answer of any question which is asked in the examination. First thing was to learn time adverbs. Second thing is to learn helping verbs. And there are two helping verbs which are used in simple future tense: shall and will. And the next one is main verb. Now I am going to teach you some examples. I blank go to market tomorrow. See this example. This one is an affirmative sentence. Okay, here we are discussing affirmative sentences. Affirmative, or you can say positive sentences also. I blank go to the market tomorrow. Tomorrow is the time adverb. Tomorrow is the time adverb. This should be the approach to write the answer. First of all, we should identify time adverb. Time adverb is tomorrow. Tomorrow is the time adverb. And tomorrow is used in simple future tense. Okay? In simple future tense. After identifying tense, we have to learn or write helping verb plus main verb. Okay? There are two helping verbs which are used in simple future tense: shall and will. Shall is used with I and we, and will is used with remaining subjects. Okay, and after that, using either shall or will, we have to put main verb, and there is only first form of main verb which is used in simple future tense. So first of all, identify time adverb. Time adverb is tomorrow. Tomorrow is used in simple future tense. Remember students, first of all we have to identify time adverb. And it would be possible if we have learnt the time adverbs earlier. Okay? Tomorrow is the time adverb. Time adverb which has been used in this sentence is of simple future tense. In simple future tense, we use shall or will helping verbs, or plus first form of main verb. Shall is used with I or we. See a subject. Subject is I. So we have to put here with I or we use shall. So we have to put here shall. Plus after that we have to use main verb. And which main verb is used in simple future tense? That is first form. So first form of go is shall go. The answer of this question is shall go. I shall go to the market tomorrow. This is the answer to this question. See the next question. Rahul write the book after 2 days. After 2 days, what do you have to do in the starting? We have to identify time adverb. Rahul is subject, write is verb, the book is object. After 2 days is time adverb, here a time adverb. After 2 days, this phrase is used in simple future tense. Simple future tense. In simple future tense, we have to use helping verb plus main verb. The helping verbs which are used in simple future tense are shall or will. As you know that shall is used with I or we, and will is used with remaining subject, plus first form of main verb is used. So this is the approach to write the answer. First of all, identify time adverb. After that, use helping verb plus main verb. Helping verbs which are used in simple future tense are shall or will. Shall is used with I or we, and will is used with remaining subjects. If there is not I or we in that condition, we have to use will. Plus main verb. The main verb which is used in simple future tense is first form of main verb. Rahul is the subject of this sentence. There is not I or we, so we cannot use shall here, because if there were I or we in that condition, we can use this one, but the subject is not either I or we, so we have to use will. Plus main verb. Main verb is first form, and the first form of write is the same, write. So answer to this question is will write. In this way, we can write the answers to the questions which are asked to us in the examination. First of all, we should learn the time adverbs. After that, we must learn helping verb plus main verbs of that particular tense. If we can learn all these three things, we can easily write the answers of the tense topic. Okay, so this is the approach. First of all, identify time adverb in the given sentence. After identifying time adverbs, we can easily identify the tense. And it would be only possible in one condition, if you have learnt all the time adverbs of all the tenses. And if you have learnt all the time adverbs, your burden of learning tense would be reduced to 50%. After that, we have to learn helping verb plus main verb. The helping verbs which are used in simple future tense are shall or will, and the main verb is first form of main verb. See the next example. We give him a prize in the next month. We blank give him a prize in the next month. See the time adverb, the next month. You can see in plus time, in plus the next month is the time of future, or you can say next plus time. Okay, so next, in the next month, this is the time adverb or time adverbial of this sentence. In the next time, this is used in simple future tense. Okay, and you know it very well that after identifying tense, we have to use helping verb plus main verb. The helping verbs which are used in simple future tense are shall and will, and after that we have to use main verb, and the main verb is first form of main verb. So we have to use either a shall or will according to the subject which is given to us in the question. The subject is we, and I hope that you all have learnt it very well, that with I and we use shall helping verb. So here we have to use shall, and the main verb which is used in simple future tense is first form. So the answer of this would be shall give. In this way, we have discussed all the time adverbs, helping verbs and main verbs of simple future tense. In the next volume, we will discuss negative and the interrogative sentences of simple future tense. Thanks for watching it.